Okay, dear colleagues, the title of presentation is given here. Here I want to discuss some problems related to definition of surface properties. So, let's say short introduction. Basic equation of elasticity with surface stresses. Maybe this is a key, will be main point, considered some effective surface properties. And then two examples of influence of surface stresses of material behavior. So, recently development of many nanotechnologies bring us new materials, and for these materials we have the necessity to consider some phenomena related, let's say, surface-related phenomena. This means that for nano-sized specimen, the influence of surface layer and something near the surface play an important role. So here we will discuss something about the description of surface elasticity. So our aim is follows. First of all, we try to discuss effective constitutive equations for two-dimensional equations describing the surface stresses, and then to analyze the influence of surface effects on the apparent or effective properties of materials at macro and nano scales. There are different models using the standard continuum approach, which using describing surface elasticity. First of all, it should be mentioned the works by Laplace, Young, Poisson, Gibbs, etc., who introduce the idea of surface tension in continuum mechanics. Otherwise, there are another surface elasticity model based on unified gradient type models related with the models of van der Waals fluid or Kartewek fluid. Recently is known that second gradient or second stress gradient theories, and one of such models was presented before by Professor Kasholas, who shown this second gradient fluence. Also, the surface elasticity models can be described with the case considering sharp interface. That means we introduce some surface which with some additional properties, or considering some interfacial layer. Then we will consider our model is based on sharp interface model. In this field, there are many papers starting from pioneering work by mentioned French and Americans. Then it was a model presented by Gerton and Murdoch, who simply represent the surface stresses as, let's say, physically it's membrane attached or glued at the surface of body, and the surface stresses is simply membrane stress results acting on this surface. There are different generalizations. For example, Stateman and Ogden generalize this model taking into account, let's say, bending stiffness of this membrane. There are influence analysis on the influence of residual surface stresses. Recently, many interesting results of finite element realization given by Evili Steinman, Paul Steinman, and they also published a review about some boundary energetic problems. So some reviews are mentioned here. So this is a simple picture describing this influence of surface standard, surface tension, describes the surface of this, you see this, let's say, structure, symbolic structure, and with some capillarity phenomena. It's surface tension may be useful, this you can maybe not see in good, but this is a water spider or water bug traveling along the surface, so at least insect use this surface tension in very, let's say, ancient time. Now, the question is, talking about surface elasticity, we should say what we mean about surface. First of all, I can say that we can assume that surface is something that's perfect, like in mathematical surface, it means no thickness, it's a mathematical description, or non-perfect surface. In this case, we can ask, is it really surface or something else? Of course, there are different, considering some, let's say, perfect surface, we mean something smooth surface. And of course, we can construct such strongly irregular surface, like fractal-like surface, for example, is what makes a fractal-like surface in fractal calculus. But this introduction of such surfaces changed dramatically the properties of mathematical equations. So, a few examples. Perfect surface, you can see this crystal, perfect crystal of zinc oxide. It's used, or very used, or often used in microelectronics for lasers, sensors, etc. And these faces are monatomic layers, so it's a perfect surface. It's proved by many results. This is another nanotubes made of oxide zincs. But it's also more often situation when we have something which we can call non-perfect surface. In this case, we see this nanocrystal array for different magnification. So it looks like a standard surface. I should say that this is a picture, but this zinc oxide is transparent. It's transparent, so it's... And you can see that at different scales, you see that this structure becomes more and more complex. So you have these structures. There are various applications of such non-perfect surfaces. One of these is shown here. It's so-called black silicon for solar cells, modifying the surface using some nano arrays we obtain, let's say, different plates made of silicon of different colors, gray and black, simply modifying the surface. Another application, self-cleaning polymer coating, which usually, I guess, many of you use in some displays, which oleophobic and hydrophobic, that means that no fingerprints. You can find modern fridges in shops that no fingerprints, so it means that you have no traces of any materials. And here we see this structure of drop lying on such surface for, let's say, almost hydrophobic. It looks like a ball. And this is a structure of such surfaces modified according to these ideas. And another example of such micro and nano fiber arrays is presented here. You also can see that we have different structures and, let's say, highly oriented and or disordered structures. For example, this is used for, let's say, biomimetic for improve the adhesion properties of surfaces. So it's now we switch to how, of course, considered such complex coating, I cannot believe that we can do it properly using the strong consideration. Strong consideration to detailed description of this geometry, proper properties of material. First of all, this geometry is very complicated, properties is almost unknown, and we are, in some cases, we are not interested into detailed description of this, let's say, micro deformation of these nano arrays, and we should somehow replace this very thin layer by some, let's say, continuum model, two-dimensional continuum model. In this field, we considered model of continuum or elastic body with surface stresses. So let us consider this body. This green surface is denotes the surface on which the surface stresses acts somehow. Other surfaces, this is a, let's say, reference configuration of this body. And here we have, in addition to in addition to external forces, we assume also the action of surface stresses. This model is related with the model of Gertin-Murdoch. So the basic equation is given here. We have the equilibrium equations. In the bulk, we have, let's say, boundary conditions and the surface with surface stresses, and we have the standard boundary conditions of nonlinear elasticity. There is a first Piola-Kirchhoff stress tensor. Being in Italy, I should also say that this is a Piola stress tensor, following to suggest strongly suggestion of of our organizers. And S is also Piola, but surface stress tensor, Piola tensor. Nabla is a three-dimensional Nabla operator, and here is a two-dimensional Nabla. It means surface. There are two basic assumptions in this theory. We can assume additional constitutive equations for the surface. It means that we have something, for example, in Gertin-Murdoch model, we have some surface energy density depending on surface gradient and some relations. Of course, there are many other general equations, like, for example, related to second gradients or more complicated formulas of boundary energetics, let's say. Second assumption is kinematical assumption on compatibility. In this equation, we consider it this position vector of surface. And usually, we assume that this position in the bulk and at the surface are coincide. When this says, for perfect surface, it's clear that you have, let's say, mathematical surface, and it's quite natural. But in general, when we consider such more complicated structure of surfaces, it's more convenient to say that it's somehow related, but not exactly coincide. And of course, this operator A depends on the inner structure of materials. So there is some extension of bulk material, surface material, so we can also assume, because we have different referential placement for surface and for bulk material, we can introduce also different referential placements, so it means we can consider the residual or initial stresses, so leads this. In more simple linearized relations, we have the Hooke's law for bulk material, also some kind of Hooke's law for linearized surface elasticity, and some constraints for the moduli in bulk and at the surface, following from the positive definites of energy. Definition of this surface module is not so simple and can be, for example, done for such bending tests for nano beams putting on some porous media. There are different, you can see some bending behavior of Young modulus following from this bending test, and you see the strong size effect observed in this field. So we consider it, say, let's say, harmonization quadrat. So we have harmonization, try to assume somehow harmonize the effective properties of surface, and then use this to average two-dimensional properties to describe pro material properties of material. So it's some idea can be described here. We have something related with surface. We have additional quantities surface stresses. This is, but here we can also consider three-layered plate with thin layered here, and one can prove, consider it, for example, tension or bending of such structures, that this surface moduli can be described as follows with some accuracy related with the properties of these layers. Now, the first attempt to do it, it's so-called foam-like surface. Here you can see the nanofoam made of zinc or oxide grown at sapphire glass, let's say glass substrate. it's a quite a regular surface. In this case, we can field, can use some approach used in at macro level. And for example, Gibson and Ashby, they suggested such formulas related with material properties, Young modulus, Shear modulus for bulk materials and for foam. And here alpha is the porosity. So it's strongly related with porosity. In the case of nanosize, that it's not so useful because in this case we have also mentioned size effect. And Wang, Duan, Karihalu, they suggested such and proved such so-called scaling law. Simply this formula is given here, so you can see that some properties of nanosize specimen depends on properties in bulk multiplied by some coefficient, where we introduce some inner length scale parameters, and R is characteristic size of specimen. So using this, we can simply write some kind of, let's say, formulas for material properties of such nanoforms. In this case, this internal length scale parameters is in such region, and usually it relates with the relation of surface tension with given for such materials. Second example is the array of nanofibers. We have the, so let's say, almost equal nanofibers array of complete, let's say, the same, almost the same sizes and heights. In this case, what we can do? Simple test for, let's say, compression give us the longitudinal moduli in this field, and also shear stresses also can calculate. We can calculate it, but since this material looks like transversal isotropic material, there is a problem related with determination of other three properties, because they strongly depend on the adhesion properties between fibers, like van der Waals forces, etc., etc., etc. Also, some contact forces. The problem is not so simple, because at this wave, in this scale, we also can consider what short range interaction, long range interaction, and something such nano fiber array bring us very good models of any generalized continuum like peridynamic second gradient, because we introduce different properties of such materials. And now I switch to some examples. The first example, simple example, we consider such nanoporous rod. We have rod with many parallel holes, and we introduce the porosity. And classical formula for strength of materials gives the same formula. So Young modulus for such specimen is given here. It's Young modulus of material multiplied by something depending on porosity. So no influence surface effects. Here only depends on porosity. So, but we can ask, for example, we have some different cross sections with the same porosity, which is should be stiffer or not stiffer, how it we should define it. So consider it different models, consider it surface stresses theory according to Gutten-Murdock model, introducing some surface layer with different properties using like a standard mechanics of composites, and modify both of them, we can obtain that effective Young modulus given here, and n is the number of pores, these channels. As a result, we have seen that this is different behavior depending on number of pores, so we have the monotonically increase. This is a line, it relates to standard bulk material. We have some kind of decreasing or increasing. So we have different properties of such effective material, Young modulus, depending on properties of each constituents. For example, you can see this dependence of Young modulus, how it depends on radius of specimen. Here D is length scale parameter related to surface stresses. This is related to interfacial layer thickness. And then you have see that there is various possibility. Then we consider a more complicated case related with the plates and shells. How many?
If you want distribution control.
Okay. So there are, of course, the good example of such, let's say, problems where we need to consider it surface models are involved, let's say, plates and shells. We can apply the same idea, describe it for the case of rod, but for such materials consistent of surface layer, interface, thin interfacial layer, and bulk material. And then applying some technique shown here in picture, we can, and some formulas which I skip for the lack of time, we can obtain the effective properties of these materials, and finally we can see that such dependence of bending stiffness, for example. This bending stiffness for different three-layered plate, classical player layer, a player layer with surface stresses, and interfacial layer. Here you can see that this behavior is given so with for thin plates and thin shells, we have that the possible is predict this size effect for small thickness. So that's all. So as a conclusion, I should say that we try to describe, to mention that there are different type of, let's say, surface-related phenomena, and for imperfect, let's say, surfaces, we have some, we can introduce some two-dimensional effective moduli, which usually, in some sense, bigger than the classical surface tension, that gives more influence for the effective properties of bulk material. That's all. Thank you for your attention.
So we have time for questions. Yes?
Welcome.
The cassera, the surface is a cassera surface, no? For example, the spirals or whatever. Do we take into account the dependence on the surface energy on the relative rotation of the fibers? Only on the rotation of a fiber relatively to the surface?
It's a nice question. For me, it's nice to answer to this. This nanofiber arrays gives a good example, but not only for Cassera surface, but let's say the more complicated two-dimensional model of, let's say, micromorphic is micro-deformation. Because in this case, we have not only, we have what we have at micro level, we have the bending of these nanofibers. We have interaction between nanofibers. This interaction is almost not, let's say, not local, not in point, because they contacted somehow. In this case, we have some van der Waals, Casimir, etc. forces acting in this field. So it gives some like material, like second gradient materials, because bending depends on them. And also we have the relative deformation between, let's say, sharing between fibers. We have some compression, different relations. So it's independent, what you mean, independent rotation of fibers with rotation of the surface. And finally, what I should say is that we have no difference between displacement, let's say, base surface of this, and displacement, limit of displacement from the bulk, because it's something else.
Can you show us the transparency last part one?
Which transparency?
This one. What is the dimension of H? What is small? Not the neck arch.
Next.
Yeah, this one. Where does this happen? What is the H is somehow non-dimensional?
In this case, it's what you want. H is the thickness of plate, because it's some non-dimensional. You can see. It depends. For example, on anodized alumina, there is thickness. This, let's say, quite difference between bulk material and nano-sized materials. It's about 20 nanometers. When you have thickness more than 50 nanometers, the difference is negligible. But it depends on the values of surface elastic moduli. And in addition, if you consider, let's say, initial residual stresses, which are in general not limited, we can obtain something very long range of influence. Saying, for example, we can obtain looks like a negative stiffness, which is completely can be described only as a loss of stability of such material.